Good evening. I want to welcome you to our Christmas Eve candlelight service. Things have sort of changed. We have a tradition at this church coming together on Christmas Eve and singing praises to our Lord and Savior. Things have changed, but that's what we're going to do tonight. And I want to encourage you as we read scripture, as we sing along with us. We do have something to celebrate. I want to start off by talking about the book of Malachi. It's a last book in the Old Testament, Prophet Malachi. And in that book, Malachi talks about the day of the Lord, a day of his coming. And after that, there's 400 years of silence, 400 years when the people didn't hear from God. And then Galatians says, then when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son. That time has come. We're no longer in silence. We're no longer having to wait. Today and tonight and tomorrow, we are celebrating the birth of our Savior. Our scripture tonight is going to be from Luke 2, 1 through 20.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town.
And all went to the town, each is his own town. And Joseph also went from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, into Judah, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David.
To be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
And in the same region there was shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone up around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for before I'll bring you good news and joy that will be all for the people.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased."
When the angels went away from them into the heavens, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see the thing that happened, which the Lord had made known to us." And they went with his haste and found Mary and Joseph and a baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known to say that had been told them concerning this child.
And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, as it be told them.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh, come rich and poor to own him, the King of Kings salvation brings, let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in the dark street shineth the everlasting light. And fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior. Sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for silver and gold from a million points of light, a reflection of something that's deeper within, just a flicker of something more. Jesus, light of the world, shine through the darkness, bright as the day. Child in a manger, kings bow down and angels sing. The Lord of the universe has come here to save us, a precious offering. All the heavens above and the earth below are filled with the light of your love.
Psalms 96 says, "Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised." Tonight, we lit our last candle. And the only reason that we can light this candle is because God's promise is fulfilled. He promised to send us a Savior, the Messiah. He promised to send us the Redeemer. And we celebrate tonight and we can sing praises because of his promise fulfilled. I know Christmas is going to look different for many families. It's going to look different for mine. But tonight and tomorrow, we can focus and celebrate on the reason, Jesus. We have reason to sing. We have reason to spread that joy to others, to be that light in a world that seems so dark. I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. I pray that God uses you to be a light in this world.
You're looking for a king the new Messiah. You're following the star, shining brighter. Old man, would you help us if you can? He shook his head, but he pointed his hand. There's a new kid in town, and he's lying in a manger down the road. There's a new kid in town, but he's just another baby, I suppose. Heaven knows there's a new kid in town here in Bethlehem. I see you've traveled far, very treasures. You say the gifts are for the new king's pleasure. I've heard that a king might come, but up till now there hasn't been one. There's a new kid in town, and he's lying in a manger down the road. There's a new kid in town, but he's just another baby, I suppose. Heaven knows there's a new kid in town here in Bethlehem. There's a new kid in town, and he's lying in a manger down the road. There's a new kid in town, but he's just another baby, I suppose. Heaven knows there's a new kid in town.